Kathy. Hello, little explorer.
Hey.
Right. Now, I finally managed to get you a new one.
Yay!
But before I give it to you, you have to promise to take better care of him.
Okay.
Better than the ones that you destroyed before.
I promise.
A moon bear for my moon bear.
I'm almost ready, Kathy. Give me 5 minutes to get into my wetsuit.
Don't overdo it, honey. School and work never stops. Just pace yourself.
No, I know. I just lost track of time. Plus, the subject matter. Fascinating.
Father like daughter, I guess. Promise?
Yes.
Thank you.
great property, just 15 minutes from the new campus.
We must have earned a free loyalty relocation at this point.
Lizzie, another one of these seasons and this entire area will be a desert.
Can we just hold off until the kids are done with school and I actually finish a residency for once?
I'm just trying to keep us safe.
Honey, the kids have a dad that commutes to the moon. Safe means something else to them.
All right.
I want to give them just a bit of normalcy, okay?
Gross!
Mummies and daddies are allowed to do this, I'm afraid.
Breaking news as we go live to the southern border of Colorado in the United States, where fighting has erupted between refugees and border troops. President Van Zandt has denounced the violence, stating that...
Weren't you going to go snorkeling with Claire?
Spectacular dive, honey.
Thanks.
Such an athlete.
I think I pulled something.
You're taking Moonbear snorkeling?
Yes.
I know, Dad. Don't worry. Come on.
Wait, darling. You're not taking Moonbear into...
Okay, bye, Dad. Love you. Better get us in the water quick before Dad catches you. Come on.
Kathy, what did I say?
But Moonbear wants to go snorkeling too.
Bring me the bear, you little troublemaker.
No.
I swear, you get this cheekiness from your mother, not from me.
Come on, Kathy, jump in!
Can you hear me?
Dad?
It's all right. I'm going to get you out of there now, okay? Come on.
Dad?
It's all right, I'm here. Okay. Ayla. ASE unit 7633-R. Ownership transfer authorization 170544. Isaac Johansson. Say the name, darling.
Kathy Johansson.
Whatever happens, you must keep Ayla close to you at all times. Never let her out of your sight, all right? It's okay. I've got you. Listen, Moonbear, we must be very quiet, okay?
No.
Just listen to me. We have to go now. We have to go. How are your legs? Can you walk?
Where's Moonbear?
We don't have time for that now, darling.
I want Moonbear.
I think it's somewhere in this room. Be quick.
Found it.
Great. Now come to me. I need your help, Moonbear. There's a button on the other side of the room. When it turns on, I need you to press it, okay?
Okay.
Now, Moonbear. You can press it now, darling. Do it, quick. That's it. Okay, it's time to go. Stay low, darling. Don't let them see you. Okay, let's go. Okay, listen carefully, darling. In the room on the other side of the vent up there is Ace.
Rose's ace?
Yes, we need to take him with us and get him back to her.
Ace likes me best. After Rosa.
Absolutely. That's why I need you to climb up there and call him over to you. Quietly.
Okay.
So they were all planning to abandon Earth?
Let's tell the team we've got the Lunar Council AC in our hands. We need to see more of these holograms.
Ace, it's me. Hi, follow me.
Number 67354-N. Initiate transfer protocol. Lunar Council override. Isaac Johansson. Code 170544.
Dad, Ace isn't like this.
It's okay. He doesn't know we're taking him back to see Rosa. Isaac Johansson. We've got to hurry. They're probably looking for us now.
Dad, my legs hurt.
Come, I'll carry you. We're going to Outward Moon Bear, together.
Artillery launch sequence initiated.
Bolt
on Vita
immediately. Yes, it's working! Wait, why isn't Vita's door opening? Come on, come on! I need to get that door open. Follow me. Quick.
Tammy! Bestie team, find another way inside the launch dome.
Artillery launch sequence initiated. Board Arc Vita immediately. Departure imminent.
Get to the door, Moomba. I'm almost through. Come on.
Alert! Launch sequence initiated. Clear blast chamber.
Dad! Back to the control room!
What do you think, Ayla? Reckon we'll get a few more months out of this relic? Yep, me neither.
Are you done yet? I feel like you should have been done ages ago.
If your butt is starting to hurt from the car seat, you're welcome to come up here and help me. You're right. You wouldn't.
Listen, MPD systems are for nerds.
Okay. Okay, bro. Just be honest. You're feeling too threatened by me and my super brain.
That super brain of yours still needs to be chaperoned to every MPD dish by a senior staff member like me. Remember?
Wait, did you finally admit that you're old?
Whatever.
Anyway, I'm nearly done. Just have to cut out some plating that's obstructing the beam's waveguide. Can you let Moonhub know the dish is ready to receive?
I already did. Don't forget to hook the stream points back up to the receivers.
Mm-hmm. Got it.
Thank you.
Now let's get the stream points hooked up, and then we're done. Let me hook up these stream points and I'll be right there. How did people cope before stream tech? Must have been a mess of cables snaking around entire living rooms.
I remember it well. Good times.
Okay, just gotta find the receiver point to connect it to. Thank you. This is the third site I've had to hook up to a stream point. These dishes shouldn't be running on emergency power.
Yeah, along with everything else in this place.
These smaller cast grain antennae can't withstand another thermal shock. Not with the prolonged power traffic that's passing through them.
You realize no one understands what you're saying, right?
Come on, even you know what a cyclotron wave rectifier is.
Okay, now you're just making up words. Hop on.
Are we still doing drinks after this?
Claire almost choked me to death last week for giving you beer.
Wuss.
Listen, your sister might not be big, but when it's something that concerns you, that woman can kill a lion with her bare hands.
So that's a yes on the drinks. Hello?
Hold on. I got a message that I've been asked to go to Maria right away, apparently for some classified emergency meeting.
Maria? Oh, then it must be really serious. Can I tag along?
No.
You only have to smuggle me past security, and then once I'm in, I'll just...
No.
Fine.
I know that fine.
Claire? You going to that meeting at Maria's?
That meeting you're not invited to? Yeah.
Please, Claire, if you just let me through security, then I'll just, you know...
I really have to go. Perhaps you can phone Brian about it.
I'll just hear about it later. It's fine.
Head down. It's been restless again lately.
Really? What happened to that diplomatic golden tongue of yours?
Didn't seem to work anymore. This is your stop.
Is it?
It is. Just let the grown-ups handle this secret meeting first.
Okay. That was uncalled for.
Just wanted to make sure you're not still gonna try anything dumb to get in.
I won't.
Don't even think about it.
Uh-huh. All right, let's go find another way into Maria's office. That's called lying, Ayla. Let's go. The museum. Yeah, we can cut through here to Maria's. Might be fun to have a look around too. Not been here in ages. Looks like no one has.
Microwave power technology is a revolutionary form of energy absorption and distribution. The Lunar MPT, along with the 42 Earth-based MPT receivers, helped stop the growing energy crisis of the 2030s.
MPTs. My jam. I got absolutely fascinated by it when I saw my dad working on it every day. He really saved this planet when he designed this.
After the Great Blackout catapulted the Earth back into an energy crisis, Claire Johansson, Maria Gonzalez, and Rolf Robertson undertook Mission Fortuna, a manned rocket mission to discover the blackout's cause. Robertson, under the guise of Johansson and Gonzalez, refueled and reconnected the MPT dish.
Claire really had such a big hand in reviving the WSA.
The Lunar MPT dish helped diminish the planet's energy crisis by massively increasing energy yields. After the Great Blackout of 2054 and the instigation of Mission Fortuna, Rolf Robertson made his way to the moon base to restart the MPT, giving his life in the process.
The WSA really is trying their best to help our world with our energy needs. I'm sure we'll get to help the entire population someday.
After the success of Mission Fortuna, Claire Johansson spearheaded Mission Vestia to provide manpower to the Lunar MPT and bring Rolf's body back home. Claire and her team discovered WSA software engineer Sarah Baker critically injured in cryosleep. Isaac Johansson, one of the three Lunar Council members and core Atwood instigators, took the last arc and escaped.
That's the last time I saw Dad. I'm fine. Just remembering it always feels... I'm fine.
Devised by the Lunar Council members sometime before the Great Blackout, Project Outward saw the evacuation of nearly all Moonbase residents on board three large spacefaring vessels known as ARCs. The location of the traitorous council members, as well as the rest of the Moonbase crew, remains unknown.
My dad designed and built most of the ARCs that they used. Like almost everything else here at the WSA. It was supposed to be an escape plan for the colony if something ever went wrong. Ayla, give that door a try and see if we get lucky. Well, worth a try. Oh, hi, Mark. Looking good, sis.
They really need to change these. I look nothing like that anymore.
Are you joking? You look so good still.
Thanks, I try.
You? Trying anything? Yeah, right. I meant that, like,
thanks.
You never have to
come on,
try.
Alex.
Are you headed to Maria's office?
No, why?
Oh, I'm just going the same way, so. Hey, I was just looking at a few of the Mission Fortuna exhibits on my way over here.
That's good.
How long were you actually stationed on the moon?
I was on the space station, mostly.
Ah, right. Yeah, that's why I never saw you on the surface, I guess.
I saw you.
Oh, really?
When I did software upgrades for Rosa's ASC.
Oh, yeah, ACE.
No, ASC.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, I named it ACE because I didn't get that ASC was an acronym, so I just kept calling it ACE, and Rosa would just start doing that too. It's kind of a confusing name, I guess.
Right.
Yours is named Alex, right?
Where are you headed to?
Wait, you didn't answer my question yet.
Question?
About how long you were stationed on the moon.
You want the years with the forced cryo sleep or without?
Sorry, I didn't mean to.
I really just need to get to the meeting, Kat.
I just wanted to apologize for what happened with my dad. I know he didn't mean what he did. I think that's why he tried to save you on the moon.
Save me? Your dad did not... Kathy, I don't want to be disrespectful, but what your dad and the Lunar Council did, they left us here to rot. They committed the worst crimes imaginable against humankind and our planet. They deserve to be punished for what they've done.
Am I interrupting something?
No?
No.
Thanks to an entire backlog of precedents, I know not to be surprised to see you here.
I made it this far. You might as well just let
me.
Maria's gonna be on video.
No.
Okay, I bet you guys rehearsed that.
We totally did.
Run at work.
I like being a rebel. Let's go.
6 years.
What?
On the moon. It was 6 years. I'm sorry I didn't answer your question earlier.
Right. Thanks.
I'm stuck there.
We need line of sight on their conversation area.
Absolutely certain.
So it must be them.
Yes. We feel that we can safely assume that Project Outward sends a signal directly to us, intentionally.
Can't believe it. They're on Mars?
You okay? Can't imagine this must be easy to hear with everything.
I'm fine. I assume we can finally justify Mission Opera then?
Yes.
Mission Opera?
Since we pulled Sarah and Kathy from the moon, we've been formulating a contingency plan, should we discover Outward's location.
During Mission Vestia, we found indications that the three Ark vessels Outward used to leave the moon weren't just for transportation. Our information leads us to believe Arcs actually form a trine, a completely self-reliant settlement.
But why reach out? Why now? Is it a distress signal or an invitation?
Doesn't matter. Mission Opera has only one objective.
Bring the Arcs and their revolutionary technology back home.
We should analyze the distress signal. Maybe we can determine the encryption used.
We're working on it as we speak. I can enable terminal access in the back office. See what you make of it.
Ada, quick. Find a way inside that room.
Perfect. Ayla, stay right there.
Wait.
What you're about to hear cannot leave this room. Understood?
Understand. I'd like to start by including Ryan and Sarah as part of the team. Not only do they excel in their respective fields, they're vital to me personally. I trust them both in my life.
That leaves one more position to be filled.
Yes.
Hey. Hi. At the risk of sounding like an idiot, I think we should take Kathy.
What?
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 She was leagues above the other graduates in our program.
You mean the only class of astronauts that we've had in the past 10 years?
Well, it doesn't change the fact that she aced nearly every exercise, sometimes even doubling my scores. I know you want to keep her out of this, but she's the best MPT engineer we've got. We need her expertise. And look, I will deny ever saying this under oath, I might add. But Kathy is the most talented individual the WSA is working for them. Apart from you two. And me, of course.
We're not seriously discussing this, are we? I mean, she has no prior experience. She's a complete risk to the mission.
Sarah's right. Kathy shouldn't be part of the team. There are too many factors involved.
How do you do this? Hey, hey, Maria. Can I come in, please?
Seriously? Please, Claire, let me be a part of the mission.
Were you eavesdropping?
Yeah, and I'm sorry for that, but Claire, you know I've proven myself to the WSA. 2 concurrent science degrees, majored in stream tech, top marks in the astronaut training program, like Ryan said. Thanks for the kind words, by the way, mate.
Sure.
And you need my MPT expertise. Please, Claire, with you by my side, I know I can do this. We can do this.
Plus, there's only, like, what? 3 other trained astronauts to choose from, so.
I think you should take her on the team, Claire.
What?
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 Nice.
She's one of the most qualified people we have at the WSA. However, the final say is yours, of course.
Okay, Kathy. Even though Ryan's last argument was severely lacking.
Yeah.
Ouch.
I believe you'll do everything you can to guarantee the mission's success. Right, Kat?
Of course.
Now I would like to go over the minutiae for the mission with Claire, Sarah, and Ryan. Can you let us handle this without listening in this time?
Oh, well, seeing as I'm now...
Kathy.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
Of course.